Mr. Ostlin, I am greeting you at UN News and welcome to Moscow.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Ostlin, could you please talk about the purpose of your visit to Moscow?
My visit to Moscow has several purposes. One of them is to address the Urban Forum on Climate Change, and I had the opportunity to speak in the opening session. I think it's very timely also to have this meeting because we know the challenges of climate change. It threatens the nature, the human health, the economy, and also our future. So we were very pleased to be invited to this forum and address the audience and the experts of the forum. Which actually linked is to sign a very important agreement with the city of Moscow. So this is an agreement between the city of Moscow and the World Health Organization by which the city of Moscow became member of the WHO Region for Health Network.
Dr. Ostlin, what perspective does this agreement open for the collaboration between WHO and Moscow?
I think many perspectives, many doors open with this collaboration, both for WHO, but also for the city of Moscow and the Region for Health Network. We have 41 regions in the network from 26 countries. And of course, it's a good opportunity for the city of Moscow to showcase the good work they are doing, but also learning from other regions on how to do things and how to implement different projects. So you don't need to invent the wheel once again. We have ready-made tools and methodologies that the city can use.
Could you please, Andy, describe current joint initiatives and activities of WHO and Moscow?
Well, actually, the agreement that we signed today, it was preceded by collaboration with the city. And obviously, we work very well, not only with the city of Moscow, but the Russian Federation. But with the city, we have been working in such a way that we invited the city to our 25th anniversary and the 25th annual meeting of the Region for Health Network. So that was a good exposure for the city to see the work of the network. Also in the environment, of course, the area of environment and health, which we see a great interest from the city to use the work we are doing on air quality, etc.
Dr. Ostlin, what issues are the top of the agenda of WHO Europe at the moment?
In the European level and of course globally also, we are working to implement our global program of work 13. This is the WHO work plan, so to speak, for the next 5 years. And we had very ambitious goals in this work plan. We had the 3 billion goals. So in the next 5 years, 1 billion more people should enjoy better health and well-being. 1 billion more people should be covered by universal health coverage. We would like to be a more modern organization, more up-to-date. Many processes going on at the moment in WHO to adjust to this new agenda. And I think we are gone a long way with that already.
Dr. Ostlin, thank you for the interview.
Thank you very much for the opportunity.